And welcome to slidecreations.com. Today we are going to learn how to create animated traffic signal diagram. The traffic signal we are going to create will give us effect something like this. Well, this is truly amazing. So without wasting further time, let's get started. To begin with, I'll start with an empty slide. I'll go to Insert, under Shapes, I'll go to a rectangle. I'll draw horizontal rectangle. So this will serve as a main pipe for a traffic signal we are going to design. I'll go to Shape Outline, No Outline. Then I'll press Ctrl D and I'll duplicate it. I'll reduce the height of this rectangle. I will also reduce its width and I'll place it here. I'm going to repeat the same procedure once again. I'll duplicate the smaller rectangle. I'll reduce its width and I'll place it here. So this arrangement of three rectangles will give us a nice 3D look later on. So I'll select all three of them. I'll go to Arrange in Align. I'll align them at center. Then I'll select all the three and I'll group them together. So this is the main part of the traffic signal. Then additional to that, we need the side focuses and front focus of the traffic signal. As shown in this diagram, you can see these are the side lamps we have and this is the front lamp. So we are going to design first one of the side lamp. So for that, again I need a rectangular tool. So I'll go to Insert, Shapes, under Shapes I'll go to Rectangle. I'll reduce. Then I'll go to Shape Outline, No Outline. Now along with that, I need one more shape to create that focus. So I'll go to Auto Shapes and I'll use this right angle triangle. I'll draw right angle triangle to give me effect something like this. So manually I'll adjust them. I'll go to Shape Outline and I'll remove the outline of this triangle as well. And I'll make sure that they are properly placed. I want this triangle to be of little bit bigger size. So I'll increase its height. Then in addition to this, I need one more curve or curvature, which I'll use this circle to create. I'll hold Shift button, I'll draw the circle. Then I'll remove its outline and I'll place it something like this. Well, so this gives us a nice effect. So in order to finally group them all, I'll select all these shapes. I'll go to Arrange. Under Arrange, I'll go to Group and I'll group them together. I'll place it exactly here. Now, in order to understand the difference, let me initially give it some color. So let me give it this color. I'll press a Ctrl D. I'll bring it here. Now, in order to make it appropriate, I'll go to Arrange. Under Rotate, I'll give it horizontal flip. Also, I want both the side lamps to be aligned with each other. So I'll select both of them and I'll go to Arrange, I'll go to Align and I'll align them in middle. So these This is the pair of lamps we have at the site. I'll press Ctrl D by selecting both of them. I'll place this new pair somewhere here again. Same thing I'll do once again. So I got these three side lamps and this main post. Now I want to create the middle lamps as well. So for that again I'll go to Insert, I'll go to Shapes. Under Auto Shapes I'll select this oval tool again. And by holding Shift button I'll draw a circle. Immediately I'll remove its outline, I'll give it some color for now, let's say white color, and I'll bring that circle here. Now we know this traffic signal post has a lamp on left hand side, right hand side, and also front facing lamp, but all of them should be of same dimension. So in order to achieve that, I'll place that circle here so that I can adjust its diameter. I'll adjust it accordingly by holding the Shift button so that I'll not disturb its circular shape. Finally, I'll keep this circle here. Now first I'll align this circle with the main post. So I'll select both of them, I'll go to Arrange, I'll go to Align and Align Center. Then I'll align this circle with these side lamps. So I'll select all three of them and then I'll align middle. So now it is nicely aligned. Fine. So I'll select this circle, I'll press Ctrl D. I'll keep it somewhere here. Again, I'll keep it here. Again, I have to align three of these. Again, align middle. Now I have to align these three and the pole. So I'll select all of them. I'll go to align and align center. So now we have the outline of the lamp created already. So the next thing what I want to do is to color these parts of the lamp. So in order to give it a 3D look, I will be using a gradient function. So I'll select this post, I'll double click it so the format shape will open. Under format shape, I'll go to this fill option. Under fill, I'll select gradient fill. Now I'll choose and the preset gradient direction, I'll be using something like this, medium gradient, and also I want it to be of linear type. Again, direction I want it from left to right. Achieve it, we can manually also adjust it. So these are the three stops I have, so I will place them exactly at 50% position with each other. I will use a very dark color for left hand side to begin with, so I'll probably choose this light gray background, darker 75%. Then I'll come to second stop. This time I will choose light gray background 50%, and for third one I'll be using a very light color, that is 25%. So this is giving a nice look. I will ungroup it. Then by selecting the three rectangles, I'll go to shape format. Under shape format, I'll go and press union. So now this is a homogeneous shape with the gradient is given there. Now gradient positions again you can change. So I was giving it some bevel, so let me come back to bevel. So top bevel is 6 and height is 6. I can try always with some different bevels as well, so it will give me as per my requirement the shape. Now I want to give some color to these side lamps also, so I'll select all of them. I'll go to shape fill. Under shape fill, I'll go to solid fill and I'll choose here a black texture, lighter black of around 50%. So this looks really nice. Now I want to create this front lamps and the lighting effect. So initially I'll be using the red color, this first circle. I'll go to shape fill. Under format shape, I'll go to solid fill. I'll choose a dark red color. So here I have already selected a color, so I'll give it a dark red color. Then I'll select the second circle. Again, I'll select the solid fill and I'll be giving it a dark yellow color. And for third circle, I'll be giving a dark green color. Now I'll select all three of them, and now I'm going to give it some outline. So I'll go to shape outline, I'll give it a white outline, and also I need the outline to be of slightly more weight. So I'll go to shape outline and I'll increase the weight of that outline to 4.5. Now this looks as per my requirement. Fine. Finally, I need one more time these circles, circular shape. So I'll press Ctrl D by selecting one of the circle. I'm going to place it something like this, so it will give me nice 3D feel. But for this front circle, I'm not going to use shape outline, so I'll remove its outline. Also, I'm going to use a different color for this, so I'll select it under shape format. I'll go to shape fill. Under shape fill, I'll go to gradient. So this is the darker color, so I'll go to more colors. So I have selected this darker color, I'll press OK. Then I'll go to the middle one, and for that I'm going to use a bit lighter color like this one. And again for the last one, I'm going to use a very light color, something like this. So this gives me a nice look, something like this. I have represented. You can further increase their accuracy by reducing and adjusting their size and position. Obviously, this looks perfect. Fine. The next thing is the animation of the text which I'm going to insert. So again, I'll go to shapes. I need this straight line under auto shapes. So by holding a shift button, I'll draw a straight line. I'll place it here and I'll increase its width. So weight I'll increase to, let's say, 3.5. I'll change its color to dark black color. And then along with this, I need a text box as well. So I'll go to insert text box. I'll draw a text box. I'll press Ctrl D. I'll keep it here. I'll press Ctrl D. I'll keep it as a third point. Now, next part is the part of animation. So initially I want this bear lamp to appear, so I'll select this entire lamp. In that, I'll just omit these three inner circles by selecting them or deselecting them, you can say. And rest of the figure, I'll group it together. I want first this lamp to appear, so I'll go to animation. Under animation, I'll go to this ready-made animation called wipe. Now I have to choose the direction of it, so I'll choose it from bottom. And also under effect options, under timing, I'll be deciding the speed of it, a medium speed. That is, it will take some time. After clicking, it will give us a nice effect. So let me reduce it a bit. 1 second. Fine. So if I'll preview it, lamp will appear something like this. The next animation I'm going to use is for these lights, and these lights will glow on click and it will be followed by the text agenda what we have written here. So for that, I'll select this circle. I'll go to animation under ready-made animation. I'll use this animation called basic zoom. So this I want to appear bit fast because it is the process of getting bulb switched on, obviously, and I want it to start on a click. But the next thing what I'm going to do is to select this circle, select this group of a text and a line, and for that I'll be using this animation called expand. But that I want to start after previous, that is, the first the bulb will glow and then this text will be animated, and I want it to appear in 1 second. Fine, once these two things are animated, I can always use a function of animation painter. So I'll use animation painter and I'll click here. Same way again, I'll select this circle, animation painter, and I'll click on the third circle. Then I'll select this group of text. I'll go to animation painter. I'll click here. Again, I'll go to animation painter. I'll click here. So entire diagram is animated. Now, the last thing what we have to do is to check the sequence of them. So initially group 52 is nothing but the lamp, entire lamp post, then oval 37 is appearing, and after that group 45. Same way, after oval 38 we want this group 46 to appear, that is text, and after oval 39 group 49 to appear. So this is how we can create the complete animation. Well, now we have animated everything as per our requirement. So let me go to slideshow and let me check the effect of what we have created. So I'll select animation. On first click, obviously the lamp will appear, the main body of lamp will appear. Then on second click, you can see the red light effect comes, then the yellow light effect comes, and then the green light effect comes. For more such videos, please encourage us by hitting the like button. Please do not forget to subscribe to our channel and share this video to more and more people. I'll catch you soon in another video tutorial of slide creations. Till then, happy presenting.